Hello everyone, my name is Auro and welcome to the 10th devlog of my base building game Chambers of Devious Design. In this devlog I will be doing all kinds of things that aren't very exciting, to tell you the truth, but they are things that needed to be done at some point. Options menu, UI stuff, game controls, Steam integration, things like that. There's a reason why I'm doing these things now, but I'll talk more about that towards the end of the video. So, now that you've been warned about the boring things, let's get started. This week, I started with adding a simple win condition to the game. I set it so that the first player who gets 100 points wins the game. I'm planning on adding different types of game modes with different win conditions to the game, but for now, I just go with a simple score limit. I of course had to add some sparkles to make the victory much more exciting. But you can't always win, so I also added a few checks to see if you run into a situation where you need to forfeit the game. After that, I decided to add a pause menu and an options menu to the game. Luckily, I didn't need to start from zero, as I got a nice head start by just copy-pasting all the code from Mortal Glory and using a similar UI panel. All the settings here are functional, but most of the changes cannot be seen within the Unity editor. While my options menu was functional, it only affected the current run, so I needed to add a saving and loading functionality to it. Like with Mortal Glory, I am using an asset called EasySave for this. If you don't want to create your own saving solution, I recommend checking it out. It has worked well for me, and the asset has a support forum where the creator is active in case you run into any issues. With a few lines of code, the options are now saved after any changes are made and loaded when the game starts. Continuing with the options menu, I decided to add support for navigating the menu with either just a keyboard or a controller. I didn't have controller support in Mortal Glory, but I decided I want to try and implement that for this game. Speaking of controls, my keybinding menu was still empty, so I needed to add a way to rebind the controls I currently have. I am using Unity's new input system, which seems pretty good, but it often isn't really that intuitive to use, and the same was true for implementing the rebinding. But with the help of a Unity showcase video and some troubleshooting, I was able to add the rebinding functionality. I also wanted to save and load my new rebinds. For this, I actually need to download a preview version of the input system, which is not really ideal, but the production version is still missing a JSON export, and I needed that for the saving. I really wish Unity will finish this package or at least keep updating it, as I would hope to not use a preview package when it's time to release the game. And to finish the work on keybindings, I added a reset button. There are still some small issues and improvements to be made, but what I have currently works okay. I already spent around 5 times longer on the input system than I would have liked to, so I wanted to continue with something else. That something else wasn't too far from the input system though, as next, I decided to make my camera movement smoother. While previously, you need to keep smashing a button to move the camera, now you can hold it down for some smoother camera control. At the same time, I made sure these controls also work nicely with a gamepad. Next, I started thinking about how to handle the different resolutions and aspect ratios that the player might want to use within the game. I did some quick research on the subject and found out that, unsurprisingly, 16:9 aspect ratio is the most common, with 1920 pixels of width to 1080 pixels of height being the most common resolution. But of course, those are not the only ones used. Aspect ratio of 16:10 is also used, and on the wider end there are also many different aspect ratios in use. Especially on mobile, there didn't seem to be any nice golden standard, and the aspect ratios varied wildly. I don't think this will really cause issues for me though. I'll focus on making the game look nice on a 16:9 aspect ratio. Making it work on a 60:10 ratio at the same time shouldn't be a big issue either. On the wider aspect ratios, the UI sections will be more separated, but otherwise, I don't expect any issues there either. If I do run into some major issues, my fallback plan is to just lock the aspect ratio to 60:9 and use black borders to pad the edges. I did some small changes already to have the UI scale better with the aspect ratio, but I'll leave most of the changes to when I have my final version, or at least near final version of the UI in place. To finish on the UI changes, I also added a quick button to toggle the UI. This should make it easier for me or the player to get some screenshots or GIFs in the game. Next, I set up the pipeline to upload game builds to Steam. To my delight, there weren't any issues and the game also works great when launched from Steam. Many have asked me to make a video about uploading builds to Steam, so that will very likely be the subject of my next video. Continuing with the topic of Steam, I also added Steam integration to my game, and I also did a bit of testing with Steam's stats feature. I'm thinking of using it to gain some information on how the players are playing the game, what are the most used winning strategies, and things like that. I feel like the Steam integration and the Steam stats might also be interesting topics, so I'm thinking of making separate videos about those also. That's as far as I got within the last 2 weeks. I mentioned at the beginning that I would also talk about why I worked on these boring necessities at this point of the development. Well, I got a reminder from Steam about their Next Fest, which features demos of upcoming games for players to try out. I read some experiences from previous festivals, and the majority of experiences were really positive. I felt like it would be a great opportunity to get some extra visibility for the game, so I opted in to the festival with my game. This meant I had to put out a demo within 6 weeks. I started working towards that, but there was constantly a voice in my head asking, "Is that too soon?" I mean, I could easily get a demo out in 6 weeks, but would it be presentable? Would it be bug-free? And would it give a good representation of what the game would be like when it's out? I went back and forth on it constantly, and I haven't actually fully made up my mind on it. But now, I'm leaning more towards that it is probably too soon. I don't want to make rushed design choices just so I can get a demo out in time. There's another similar festival planned for February, and you can only participate in one of these. So now I'm thinking I might instead participate to the one that's in February. By then, my game should be nearly done, if not already completely done, so I can come up with a much more polished demo and make a better impression. Even if I do end up opting out of the October festival, I figured I would still keep working on the boring necessities, so in case there are some unexpected opportunities later in the year, I'm not so far away from a functional demo. But hey, that's everything I had to show and talk about in this devlog. Sorry that this one was a bit boring. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.